Welcome to Weld.com. And I don't know why I'm saying that first, but I'm with Mr. Shawn Lowry, Mr. Sawblade Head of Designs, man. We hadn't talked in quite a while, but we were hammering and egging on the phone, and we were talking about metal finishes and what you see, I see, and all the options that we can do with finishing and stuff. And I think we ought to start banging out some videos on different finishes of different materials for the sole purpose of when you do a repair or you fabricate something or whatever, you got to take it back to either the original finish or you're creating your own finish, right?
Yep.
I mean, if I go into a kitchen and I got to do a repair on this beautiful stainless tube that you brought over, I better match that finish, right?
Yep.
So we got to learn how to do that. Anyway, I think today we're going to do this video is going to be a shorty on what you can do. Carbon steel, aluminum, stainless, and we'll play with some copper too. So what's first on the list?
I would say we got some copper sulfate.
We do. Yeah. Well, I brought some copper sulfate too, yeah.
That gives us a nice that'll, patina over a copper and a carbon steel.
Yeah, and carbon steel. I'm kind of experimenting with other materials. So we can do it on both a smooth finish here on this carbon steel and one that we've scratched on in various, in a pattern. So the next one would be an aluminum, you know, and aluminum looks, you know, it's clean. It's got the etch over here from being welded. It's got the dull gray from the oxidation. And here's where I just hit it with the die grinder and the sander over there. So definite color difference getting through that oxide layer. Again, your stainless steel, nice and clean. Nothing really ever happens to this. It just goes on through life looking like this. Might get dust and water stained or something, but it just cleans up with the
you might get that greenish patina on it for being outside, but it'll wipe right on off.
And then good old copper, it does get the green patina on it. UV light, water, moisture, and time, just it'll dull this thing out.
And we're gonna experiment with torch and heating that up and get some colors.
We want to do a little coloring if we could, and we might do some experimenting with some copper sulfate on it just to see if there's a reaction. I don't know, but the importance of all this, and there's just a plethora of abrasives that you can grab. Some of them are aggressive, some of them are geared toward blending and polishing, some of them are just the plain old wire wheel on a die grinder or a drill. Some of them are aggressive wire wheels.
Yep.
And I'm not here to name brands or anything. There's some fantastic products out there. We've got a little bit of rouge. Mm-hmm. We've got some rouge. We'll play with some rouge.
Yep. Got the green and we got the gray, which is a good, that's pretty much kind of does the whole gamut of all the metals from copper to stainless.
The gray one does?
Yeah.
Stainless steel. The green and stuff aluminum.
But this is for high polishing.
Coins and copper and stainless. Yep. I mean, it's a nice finish when it's done.
This is mainly for protect from scratches. It gives that restoring.
Grinding is an art. You can ruin a part with a grinder. Seriously, it's, you know, if you're putting something together out here on the outside corner to corner, and you're not grinding correctly, you could gouge that all up. And it might look fine for you while you're fabricating it, but when you finish, you paint it or something, you're walking by it in the right light, you're going, ooh, what happened there? Looks like it's all dented up and everything. So grinding will make or break a project, as a matter of fact. Files, I see you got some files over there.
Yep.
You learn how to file. That's that's craftsmanship right there. So anyway, first up, we want to do some hacking away on the old carbon steel here. What do we want to do? We want to polish some of it? We want to do the copper sulfate? What do you want to do?
I'd say let's make a mess. I would say polish it, and then we could hit it with copper sulfate.
First thing I want to do is change abrasives here because that's what cleaned that up, and it's pretty aggressive. Mm-hmm. So the next thing I'd want to do in that SEP system over there, let's go with the red pad in front of you, the red jobber out front. Okay.
You don't want to even try that
let's just put a zerk on here, 40 grit, and just come off of it smooth as all. You know, so we got super rough, scratched up. We've got something that's fairly controlled. You know, another thing we should have mentioned, like the DA. I love running DA on aluminum, the orbital type random sander. I love that finish. So we want to do this. And then we talked about doing a copper sulfate. Do you want to do that now for... We probably should because it's not going to show up on... We're not going to do it to all these metals here, so let's just go ahead and do it now. So I'm going to dribble some on there. Immediate copper, because I mixed this in a little hot. It's a little harsh. We can stand back. We'll get a light mist on there, too. So all three of those just got a nice, generous shot down through there, and we can go blow it off the air hose, but... I've done this before. I kind of like it. Better living through chemistry, I always say, huh?
Let nature take its course.
And hard facing and all kinds of other cool stuff. So there's that. We go blow that off of there, then we could preserve that. I like blowing them off, and I like rinsing them off. This, you can tell where I've made it drip down that direction, but, you know, there's some color. And then leave it on there overnight and see what happens. We ought to do that. Yep. We'll leave it out back, let the lizards play with it tonight.
And you can also do it in layers, and it'll react differently as time goes on, like that layer.
Oh, versus layers, it will?
Yep.
All right, we'll do that. Does it do anything to aluminum? What do we do with aluminum? Well, we can clean it, clean the oxide layer off of it. We can polish it. That's just cleaning the oxide layer off. Where's the little toothbrush at?
Brush look.
Right here. We knocked that oxide layer off. A lot of people haven't seen this. They think it's clean, but it isn't. And you want to brush in one direction, if at all possible. Doesn't feel like this brush is cutting into it, but it's going to start to here in a sec. So being patient, you can start getting into this surface, and you want to brush it in one direction, but that's your oxide layer right there you're looking at on my finger. And what's odd is aluminum melts at, let's just say 1200 degrees, depends on what it's alloyed with, but the oxide layer melts at 3700 degrees. So as far as finishing, I've gone in and done the skip sand where let it roll around in here. I don't do anything. Have you ever painted? I haven't. Aluminum doesn't take paint, does it?
A powder coating, but you can still.
Powder coating, yeah, but.
It's more so for decorative, but like you said, it's, you know, I've done it where it's a matte finished. I've used the wire wheel to get that kind of solid brushed look, but it's a softer look. You'll still get the brush look, but it's a softer muted look. And then this way, the paint actually grips it better because you're down to the pure metal.
I see what you're saying. So you create a texture that the paint adheres to, and you can get. Have you ever clear coated this? I have not, I don't think.
Powder coat, clear coat, yeah.
Powder coat, clear coat. All right. You're talking about stuff I can't afford over, you know. But what do we do with the stainless steel? I'm scared to touch this thing. It's so nice, you know. You can hit that with a wire wheel. It still looks stainless. You can rough up the surface of it, I guess. Mm-hmm. Do you mind? We're going to do that for demonstrative purposes? Or?
That's right.
I mean, that's brush.
Yeah.
And it's in line with the tube, so obviously that went through some kind of machine to make it that perfect. That's a nice finish. Mm-hmm. That, I mean, this is like restaurant type stuff here. Huh?
Yep.
And then I roughed it up a little bit. And you could rough it up even more if you wanted to.
Yeah, we do this side.
But how do we, have you ever polished it from there?
The stainless steel? Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to take this part that we just roughed up and quickly take the scratches out and bring it back to that. But we're going to go beyond this here. This is a brush, but we're going to go past that and go to a polish.
Yep.
So we want to go from here. We probably want to go blue first. We'll go blue first. Get those scratches out. I got these back of that right there. Just kind of lightly hit that and bring it off with low pressure and slow speed. Slow travel speed, I mean. That tube's making an odd noise. It sounded like you, I better not say it. Let's see what we got here. All right. Oh, yeah. There we go. You said you've used this before?
Yeah, I've used the green before. This is the high polish, so you want to use the green.
We'll go this route. Oh, okay. Right. I see what you're saying. Have fun.
See a little bit of difference. Hopefully, the camera can pick that up.
We polished this. We obviously can rough that up. That helped a bunch that it was even at that state, where it's just the brush, because it wasn't a whole lot of work. Now it brings us back to the copper. Look what happened. I put some copper sulfate on this before we started, and it's just kind of sitting here, and it looks like it's kind of gumming up.
Yeah.
I don't think it's doing anything, really. Did we shear something off of this the other day? Or is there a thin piece like this that we want to play with? This was the part that we played with the other day.
How it crystallized.
And this thing has heat and crap all over it.
Tons of heat.
Beat it up and everything. And went over it with multiple flames experimenting. And then we shot some copper sulfate to it. And it looks like some kind of acicular grain, like a ice or something on there, doesn't it?
It looks like ice on a window.
Exactly.
It's all crystallized.
And you know what? It ain't wiping off very easy either. One of our viewers out there in Weld.com land, and I know they know this, they're chemistry professors and smart folks. So help us out here. What have we created? It's like we've created a monster. And I've never done this before. We're showing what we've done, what we're comfortable with, and then we created this monster here. So what do you do with it? I'd clear coat it and go with it. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's got some wild colors in it, you know? Where'd that long piece go right there? Mm-hmm. So what do we do with it? I mean, this is polished. This is stuff that you can buy. I tend to do stuff like, and everybody knows why I do it. No two pieces will ever come out the same. Put that skip sand on there and let a die grinder or roll lock wheel hit it. If you polish something, it's got to be perfect, right? I mean, you're going to see every flaw. And if you do some imperfections to hide imperfections, that's one thing. But then how do you preserve all this? Because what does copper do?
It's going to turn
green. You know, it's that oxidation, that patina that copper does.
Now, we can either, depending on what the piece is for, you resin dip it, you can clear coat it, you can...
We had a bank in our community that had copper out there on the around the windows and stuff, and you see people with really nice homes that have copper dormers. Well, for the most part, the dormer isn't seen, the top of it isn't seen, the face of it is, but they turn green. And it's, I mean, this is more blue, but they turn kind of a green color, and it's like well, that's what it's supposed to do, and that's what architects like eventually, I guess, that they want that color and that oxidation. Once it does that, then it quits, doesn't it? It's like a Texas paint job on a bunch of carbon steel and a brick ranch front. Texas paint jobs rust.
Yep.
And once it does that, then it quits rusting because it's got the covering on it. So, I mean, that's interesting. Mm-hmm. I don't know there's got to be some products that you preserve that with, obviously. But then that heat coloring thing. I'm not an artist at it. I know people that are. I haven't had time to play with it, but I am going to study it and get into it. Let's throw a little heat to this thing. So I want to come over here and just kind of, I want to destroy this coloration we've got in here. It's nice polished, and I just want to go for this and kind of gray it. Kind of knock that down and get it gray for a reason. Yeah, I'm done. There's my art.
Mm-hmm. It's minimalistic.
Yeah, then how do I preserve that? That's the deal. I'm wondering how the gentleman with Phoenix Flame Art still need some information now, that gentleman. Not to take everything or try to type the ideas or anything else, but It's a community. That's some pretty cool colors. I know the camera guy's over here and he can't see it, but, and I'm not going to reach in there and show it to him either. I know that's hot. I'm the one that, can you see that very well? How about that? I mean, those are some cool colors. Now we got to control them. You know, how do we create the Weld.com logo and put that color in there? Well, I think we better figure that out. And again, I've always done this scratch skip polish thing. Hand me the die grinder and the air hose. And I'll rough one up here. You know, I like the contrasts that come about. Polish, this, and the scratching and the rough stuff. You know, I always like those contrasts. It's like doing a piece of art or anything. Where you do something where it's the contrast, you know, with like between stainless and copper and glass and wood and all that. I just like all that kind of different stuff mixed together too. Anyway, that should give you some ideas. Give us some questions. Send us some suggestions of what you'd like to see. If you're an expert at this, please chime in. You're more than welcome to come in and shoot some vids with us. Always have been. And again, thank you for your time.
Thank
you. Haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah. We'll be working on some bigger projects.
We'll pull out some, we'll go to the junkyard and get some ideas going. That's where my mind starts clicking, you gotta unfortunately.
Just come to my warehouse.
Nuts it's and full. Bolts and elbows and fittings and all that stuff, man. My mind just goes nuts. Especially when somebody's asked me to do a repair. Do you have this? No, but I don't have it, but I know where it's at, you know. That's so bad. That repurposing stuff and redoing repairs these days, like restaurants and all that stuff, man. It's so hard to get anything done, in my opinion. Everybody's throwing stuff away.
Yep.
I don't like throwing stuff away. I like fixing it, rebuilding it. So you close us out there, will you?
All right, guys. So if you got any questions or projects you want to see Bob and I go ahead and work on, it's something we want to do in the future. You got to come to my warehouse, pull out some parts and create something, but also check out the Weld.com app.
Absolutely.
Yep. Tutorials, jobs, more stuff on Bob.
You don't put stuff like Bob on there. You don't want to ruin that page with that. That's boring. Check out the app, folks. That's where it's all going to go anyway. And it's just a meeting place of everything. Everything's going to come together on that app. So please check out the Weld.com app.